What's up, guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. First of all, I want to say thank you, David Young. David Young went out of his way and sent me, Jay Young, Snap-on Tool Review, Snap-on Tool Junkie. I think Snap-on Tool Review. I'm not sure. Have to ask him. Sent us all each a little something, and it was very, very nice of him. I got his. I'm going to save it. You know what? Like, it was such a nice gesture. I'm really shocked. It was really, really nice of him. Next thing I want to say, if you guys haven't yet, go check out Jay Young's brother, the Toothpick. Check out his videos. His videos are funny as shit. Check out Teach You How to Shave Like a Man. It's named something like that. Very funny video. I'll link his channel in the description down below. Check that out. And for today's video, we got something pretty cool. It's probably by far my favorite Snap-on catalog yet. Like, I really, really enjoyed it. Obviously, the stuff in there is a little expensive, but it's probably, this catalog consists of probably some of the coolest Snap-on items they have. If you guys like the 14.4 volt family, make sure you definitely continue watching, because there's a lot of that in here and a lot of other cool things. So let's get into the video. Okay, so first of all, here's what David Young sent me. This was my package. All right, we got two of these year charts. Every Snap-on tool has a stamp in it, and then this tells you what marking, what year the tool was produced in. So these are pretty neat to have. He sent one for me and one for Bill, and he sent this 10 millimeter, which is awesome, because 10 millimeter, everyone knows 10 millimeter is probably the most common socket and wrench. And this is the letter he wrote. He said, "Bruce, this is my only Snap-on tool I have, and I'd like you to have it. Hope you like this Snap-on chart. P.S. Give one to Bill, please." David Young, I will give one to Bill first thing in the morning. I really appreciate that. It honestly means a lot. You know, like, just the way you wrote it, like, I will keep this, and this will stay in my box no matter what. Stuff like this doesn't go unappreciated. You didn't have to send me a tool, dude. You really didn't. I'd rather have letters and stuff, but always getting something like this is very nice. The thought means more than anything, and I really, really appreciate it. So, thank you much from all of us. Jay Young, Justin, all of us. We really appreciate the kind gesture. Now, moving along into the catalog. Again, this is probably my favorite catalog by Snap-on so far. It's called Textra. I don't think it's like any particular month or anything, because it doesn't say it. It's just maybe an extra catalog, Textra. So, here we go. First page, we have the 18 volts cordless tools. And I don't own any 18-volt cordless tools. They're really, really pricey. And honestly, I don't have the extra money for 18-volt tools. Stuff like this, I just use air or corded tools. It's not really my personal choice to buy stuff like this. Although the cordless impact, which I do not see, is good for road service. So you have your grinder, your drill, your Sawzall. This is a dent puller tool, but you need this to use it, so it's pretty neat. Paintless dent repair. You get some drill bits here, and now over to the 14-4 family. This gun, this is amazing. It's amazing. 376. Now the kit, anything that says kit is gonna come with, I don't know why this isn't focusing, I'm using my phone, is going to come with two batteries, the charger, and a bag along with the item. So, is it a bit pricey? Yes, but I'll tell you what, I really like this gun. I haven't gotten a chance to use the Makita like a lot of you guys have suggested, but I'm definitely going to try something else soon. I'm not going to get the Snap-on Ratchet. I'm going to try the Makita one and see how I like that. Was it Makita or what was the other brand? Milwaukee. Try that one, because those are on sale right now. But this right here, this is amazing. Joel did a video on this. If you guys want, make sure to go check it out. And my two Snap-on guys, Alex and Doug, they have this on their truck, and it's amazing. It really, really is amazing. For exhaust work, especially, just cut if you're taking out a whole exhaust and you're putting something in or whatever it might be, just cut it right out. That thing cuts like butter. Then you have the cordless prep tool. This is pretty neat. I wouldn't mind getting that. I do have the Blue Point air prep tool, but that I didn't even know this existed until I saw the catalog. That's pretty neat. Then you have your temp gun. That's pretty cool. And then of course your drills. I did order this right here, the 14-4. This is the underhood light, and as you can see, it clamps under the hood. It's also good for putting it in the interior car if you're doing a stereo work. It'll open both doors, and then you can hang it from the roof on the inside. Again, is neat. And then, as we all know, I bought this guy here. And this one here for $166, if you already have the batteries, that's really not a bad deal because these are pretty pricey as it is, no matter where you get them from. I realize you can get them cheaper, but I think this is a really good deal. And our Snap-on guys, if we talk to them, or depending on how much we buy, they're not like the stuck-up normal Snap-on guys. If we purchase a good amount of stuff and we ask, like, say, hey, can we get this for $10 cheaper or whatever, they're really, really cool about it. They're just both really great guys. Moving along here, we're into air tools now. Bill did some vinyl work for me. And he was really wanting the Crud Thug, and I had it. So in turn, for payment, I offered him the Crud Thug, and he said sure. And I think he got about $100 worth of work he did for me in vinyl, helping me out one night. So I know he really wanted it, and I wanted to help him out, so I gave him the Crud Thug, and he loves it. He uses it all the time for alignments and such. And then we have another angle grinder, extended reach die grinders. Those are always handy. What's the difference between this one and this one? 1 horsepower, half a horsepower. Okay, so this one's stronger. Pretty pricey, but I don't know if you can get those in any other brand. I haven't seen them. We got the hand sanders. These would be good for guys that do speaker boxes and body work and stuff like that. Those are pretty cool. The cutoff wheel. I really like the style of that. That one's nice. This one, I believe Bill has this one of these, and it's really nice. What are the prices? I don't know why this camera will not focus. 284, 379. Yeah, they're up there, but they look really nice. I know some people aren't crazy about Snap-on's prices, but we know how that goes. 18 volt power inverter, micro lithium USB power unit. Now this, I just wouldn't buy this for one reason. This here is a 3-bay 14-4 charger, which is nice if you have a lot of shit, but if you end up buying kits and stuff, you wind up with a few chargers. So one, you won't need it there, and two, the batteries charge in 40 minutes. You get a full dead to full in 40 minutes. So unless you have a whole bunch of stuff, I don't see a point in that. And that's a very expensive charger, so I don't agree with that one. Let's see here. Now we got drills and stuff. That's the 3/8. What number is that? That's the MG325. I think Joel has that one. I do like this air hammer. I like the way it looks. I did the video comparing the new IR to this. And they're pretty similar in specs. And the IR I got for $200. But I do like the look of it. Same with all their stuff. What else we got? We got the ratchet, 3/8 drive air ratchet. If you guys have ever tried the impact air ratchets, let me know in the description, because I've been curious about those things. They're big, they're bulky, but from my understanding, they're really, really powerful. So I'd like to hear you guys' input on that, because Bill and I have been looking into getting them. More so Bill, but this is a handy tool right here. And it's reversible. I did not know it's reversible. My MAC cutoff wheel is reversible. These are really nice to have. They get in all sorts of places. This here is a pinstripe remover. I'm sure you can use it for other things, but these here are for pinstriping. It's like a rubberish material. And how I use these here is I pull the pinstripe off first and then use this for the glue and stuff afterwards. Just so it's less material to have to, because I don't like anything on paint, even if it's paint friendly. Reciprocating saw, those are pretty nice to have. I know these here at Harbor Freight, if you're just looking for a throwaway, they're like 20, 30 bucks or something like that. Blowgun. Now we're getting some cabinets, Blue Point cabinets. These again are up there. I don't know how this ranks for $4.59. I'm not sure of the quality. Then we have the racks. See, me here personally, I'd go to Harbor Freight. But here's the thing, guys. When you use the Harbor Freight racks and you put the sockets on them, the way Snap-on prints their sockets, I guess you could say, or however their die is, if you use these ones here, go upside down, I guess you would say, and Snap-on's writing is upside down. So these work perfect for Snap-on. If you do use the Mac or the Harbor Freight ones, then they are they'll be upside down. But you can still see, obviously, what the tool is because the rails are marked. But they're 20 bucks for all six of these at Harbor Freight. And another reason why I don't like these here is because if your sockets are filled with dirt or whatever, and you go to put them on, it gets the tip of the pins all dirty. So, but that's just my preference. I know a lot of people that have these and they do like them. So if that's your cup of tea. And this is the tray I've been telling a lot of people about. I will be getting this. I will be getting this. I like it because it slides under the front of the vehicle. And then this essentially is under the in the engine bay with you with all your tools on it. And I think for $179.90, I don't think that's a bad deal at all. And Doug had it on his truck. And I almost bought it. And I think he was going to give it to me cheaper than this, actually. And I bought something else instead. So I did not buy it. But this is going to be a future purchase. And we got welding stuff. There's one helmet that was really cool. I like this one. And this helmet's badass. I really like that one. Just the shape of it. Let's see. What else we got here? We got welders. Expensive mammer jammers. But so we got welders. I've done stick and TIG, but I about lost my mind. I'm no good at it. I'm good at MIG, not stick and TIG. So I'll just briefly go over this and you guys can check that out. These are the big boys. So that's pretty cool. Now we've got, what else we got here? Sheet hooks, chains, that sort of stuff. Dent killer. Oh, this is all body, paintless body repair stuff. Now, if you can get good at this, there's a lot of money to be made. A lot, especially places where it hails. My buddy has a business called the Dent Grappler. And he makes a fucking fortune. He really, really does. Again, more dent pulling stuff. This is cool. It's $12,300. But it's got the, let me focus in there. It's got everything you need for paintless dent repair. And it's all in the foam trays. So that's really, really cool. I'm sorry if this video ends up being blurry, guys, but you'll get the gist of it. This is just a quick video because I have the catalog. This is just gloves and safety equipment, stuff like that. Here's a shop vac. How much is this thing? You got a Blue Point for $184, 5 gallon. And then you have a two-stage wet-dry vac, 16 gallon for $450. Now, I don't know how much these cost, but maybe that's not a bad deal. I wouldn't think so anyways. See, I've got my vinyl plotter, so I can really just take any. Maybe it's my one. I could just take any vacuum, paint it, and stick a thing, a sticker on it. Now, here, Doug, my Snap-on dealer, was telling me about these when I went to buy, order my other one. Now, he mentioned something really, really cool about this. This works just the same as the others, except it has this here. And this is 1500 lumen. Let's see how much the, we'll mark this page. This one here is 1500 lumen. And mine there is 800 lumens for this long one here. So it's pretty much double, slightly under double. And it's this little thing. Also, too, from what he was telling me, you can buy more of these and add them onto the rail, which is pretty stellar. He said this is a very hot item. They're on back order. And I was playing with this on the truck, and it's really neat. You have your LED here, and then you flip it over. You flip it up this here, and then you have a stick light LED string, string of LEDs right there. Pretty neat. You get some cell phone holders, stuff like that. Bill has this guy here, and this thing's pretty impressive. I think it's like a 3 or 4 LED light. And how many lumens is it, does it say? It doesn't say how many lumens it is, but it's pretty bright and it's magnetic. So that's a neat little light to have. Now we got your digital multimeters. Contact laser tachometer. These guys here. Battery testers. Now, how much is this guy? See, this guy here, it's $396. When I was at Keystone, had the commercial account, I got it for 160 or 170. Might even been 125. It was definitely under 200 and under 175. And I didn't like it, but and one of the reasons was the clamps here, and it looks like they did upgrade them. So that's good. It kept telling me it wasn't connected to a 12 volt power source or whatever. It worked on everything else, but on cars it kept saying battery or not connected, not connected. So I gave that back. And like after going from the commercial account, it sucks because this guy here was just under $200. I bought it and then I didn't use it, so I returned it. And on here it's 544. Unless this might be a bigger screen or something, I don't know. 4.3. No, it might be the same. Then you have your guns, your solvent gun, sandblaster, thermometer, TPMS tool, $1,700. But these things, boy, they're nice to have. Now we're into jacks. The jacks, we all know about jacks. You can get these things here for $269 each. You roll them under the tire, roll and put slide this so the tire's in between. Then you jack them up. You get four of them, and then you could dolly a car around, and then you can get this cool rack. And then push the rack around and keep them all on there. And then you have these. I was actually going to build one of these. I have an airbag from a truck for the suspension. From, I think it's a Mack truck or a Freightliner. And I was going to mount it to a jack right there. And then hook up the valves and stuff. And then send air to it. And literally it'll lift the car in like 0.2 seconds. It'll and flies right up and the car is jacked up. So I think that's essentially what that does. And you have your Solus Edge, your Vantage Ultra, your Ethos Pro. Ethos Pro, I wouldn't even bother with an Ethos Pro because you can get something just as good or if not better for that price of the Ethos Pro, you can get the Maxxis. But I know a lot of yous don't like that. But now here's your Tech Angle Torque wrenches. These things are amazing. I would suggest only getting the half inch, but some of you guys might want to get the quarter inch and 3/8. But they're pricey. They're as you can see here. But man, are they awesome. They're amazing. If you're gonna buy one of these right here, I would definitely recommend you spend the extra, what is it, three, we'll say 350 and then 550, the extra $200. And get the tech angle because that tells you your angle. Like if you have to put an extra torque it to 300 foot-pounds and then put an extra 90 degree turn on the bolt or fastener. That'll tell you exactly when you're at 90 degrees. It does so much. It really, really is nice. You have your flex heads. These are old school. Max and snap-ons are the same in this style. Same exact torque wrenches. Oh, here you go. Here's an electronic torque. Comparator. Sorry, you got tongue-tied there for a second. This will help you calibrate your torque wrench and tell you if it's off or not. Bill got these. These are really, really nice. I like them. The non-marring scrapers, those are pretty cool. And for 41 bucks, it's not too bad considering they are snap-on. You got your big dead blow. Some blue point keys. I wouldn't even bother with those. Trim panel remover. Windshield remover. You got your nut drivers. Hard handle nut driver set. Your instant grip screwdrivers. I think everyone's got those. Knives, ratcheting screwdrivers, and then your precision screwdrivers. Getting down to the nitty gritty here, this is also a future investment of mine, the BJP1. It's by far hands down the best ball joint tool ever. Because it holds everything together for you. It's slotted out for the grease fittings. The clamp here does not bend. Even the OTCs, if you look at them, they do stretch and they do bend. This does not. The adapter sets are really expensive, but they're worth it. And this here too also tells you, it comes with a book. So say you're doing a 2000 Dodge Durango or something, whatever. I don't even know if there is one. But it'll tell you what pieces you need to do it, so you don't have to sit and try and figure it out. Filter wrench stuff. Here's your wrench set, $405. 281. I mean, it's expensive, but for some reason that just seems really, really cheap to me. Oh, that's also not. That's a standard too. Then you got your crow's feet. Where's that? Oh, this here too. There's only three things in this catalog I will have. It's that BJP1, whatever it was I mentioned back there, and these. These are great for like your banjos. Like whenever you disconnect a brake caliper, you use these and it'll plug the holes so they don't, rather than pinching the line and stuff, you just plug these and it plugs the banjos and they don't leak. So it comes with four different sizes of those, and then you have your line pinchers. Really nice set, and it's under $100. It was funny because I was asking my Snap-on rep for these and he couldn't think of it, couldn't find it in the book. And he's pretty good with finding stuff really fast and knowing all the part numbers, but we couldn't find it, and then it just pops out in this catalog, so that worked out really well. And now, these are awesome. This one here, does road force and everything, $6,000. Look at these tire machines, these are nice. Obviously really pricey. And yes, guys, we know you can get the sets. You can get the tire balancer and changer on eBay now for like it's like $800 or $900 for the pair. But you gotta remember, those are cheapo brands. And then how easy is it gonna be to get parts if it breaks or whatnot? We don't know. But if you are just starting, that would be an alternative route, because this route is really expensive. But man, these are just really nice pieces of equipment. They look good. They'd make your shop look good. But it would cost a lot to do so. But anyways, guys, that's it for this video. It was just a quick catalog review to go over and talk about what's in it. It had some cool stuff in it. I think it's one of the best ones just because it had a lot of cool stuff in it. You know, like all the 14-4 stuff, the electron or the electric guns, and it's just a really, really cool catalog. Some of the prices weren't too bad, but we all know it's Snap-on and we know how that goes. There's nothing we could do about it. So we just got to roll with the punches. If we don't like it, we don't buy it. If we do like it, then we buy it. Simple as that. So no need to go hating on me for making a Snap-on video. Make sure you guys check out the links in the description for tools on Amazon, cheap tools. Tecton and all that stuff are discounted prices. If the prices don't match, that's because they're out of stock of it in that price. And so it's going to bring you the next best price. I'm going to update that soon. I've been really busy. I said that before. Also, my shipping address is down there. If you guys want to send letters or whatever you want to do like that, I saved them all and I'm going to hang them all up. And I really like getting letters and stuff. So that's in there. And that's it for this video. I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.